We've seen how to collect observability data from services running in Google Cloud. But what if you still have services on-prem or in other clouds? Today, I'm going to show you how to determine the right observability strategy for a hybrid or multi-cloud environment. This is the Stack Doctor. Before we start, let's talk about what hybrid and multi-cloud really means. People often think that hybrid and multi-cloud means having a single workload that runs across multiple infrastructure providers. But in practice, this rarely works as advertised. The added latency and cost of network egress makes this largely impractical. We see much more success with a hybrid model where different providers are used for different workloads and often by different teams. However, this introduces observability challenges. How can you standardize things like SLOs, observability, and alerting across all of these platforms? Generally speaking, you have two options. The first is to use Google Cloud as the single pane of glass and send your observability data from other platforms there. There are well-documented integration options for this, and I'll get into those shortly. Your second option is to use a third-party service as your single pane of glass and have it consume observability data that's either collected by cloud monitoring and logging or emitted directly by your Google Cloud resources. Let's review a few examples for the first option, using Google Cloud as your single pane of glass. You may need to ingest observability data from multiple platforms, monitor Kubernetes clusters, or collect logging data from multiple sources. You can use Bindplane, a solution from Bloomador, a Google Cloud partner, to import monitoring and logging data from both on-prem VMs and other cloud providers. This architecture has one main advantage. There are no additional licensing costs for using Bindplane. Bindplane metrics are imported into cloud monitoring as custom metrics, which are charged at standard rates. Likewise, Bindplane logs are charged at the same rate as other logs. If you're looking to monitor workloads on Kubernetes clusters running both in Google Cloud and elsewhere, you can use the combination of Prometheus, Cloud Monitoring, and the Cloud Monitoring Prometheus sidecar to ingest Prometheus metrics into monitoring for a unified monitoring approach. Finally, you can use a similar approach to collect logs from multiple Kubernetes clusters by using Fluentd, a popular open source logging agent, and having it send both infrastructure and application logs to cloud logging. We've now covered using Google Cloud as your single pane of glass. Let's look at our other pattern, exporting data from Google Cloud to our third-party service. In this scenario, there are two primary methods of sending that information. The first method involves the third-party tool integrating with the monitoring API to consume metric data. For logs, you'll have to set up a cloud logging export to a PubSub topic. You'll then be able to connect your preferred tool as a subscriber to receive those logs. For the other method, you may choose to leave the data where it is and simply aggregate at the presentation layer. Grafana is an excellent way to achieve this and can be used with multiple backends, including cloud monitoring. I hope this walkthrough of common architecture patterns to build out a hybrid or multi-cloud approach to observability with Google Cloud helps you as you plan your journey. That's it for this episode. Come back soon for more. This is the Stack Doctor. Stay healthy out there.